this is SGU, and welcome back to my Florida Panthers, well, soon-to-be Hartford Whalers relocation franchise in NHL 17 on the Xbox One. We have hit the playoffs, and we have hit the playoffs as a number one seed with the Florida Panthers. However, we've hit a little bit of a roadblock to start this first series. The number eight seed, Philadelphia Flyers, have taken it to us so far, taking a 2-1 series lead and a chance to put a stranglehold on this, go up 3-1 on their home ice. We got to make sure that doesn't happen. Wearing throwback uniforms tonight. Love this era of Florida Panthers jerseys. I like the new ones too. I think they're really sharp. But I'm rolling with these for game four. We've put the Flyers in their Stadium Series jerseys, featuring the really, really oversized numbers on the sleeves and on the back. So let's get at this. No score later stages. Actually, just last couple seconds of the first period. That is stopped right there by Mason. Puck goes in the corner, then behind the net. We have no score after one in game four. A very important game, especially for the Panthers. Feeling the heat here, being the number one seed, not wanting to be bounced in the first round. You got a move and a shot on net by Jaromir Jagr, and the rebound is slammed home right there. That's a beautiful play right there. The shot by Jagr actually ends up just being get that on net and create a rebound, essentially, because he puts it right off his pad and right to Jokinen's stick. That is beautiful right there to give the Florida Panthers the 1-0 lead. Man, I don't get that many rebound goals in this game, and when I do, it feels pretty darn good. So there you go. You got Luongo making a save, and you got the Panthers going the other way, trying to rush up ice here. That's Ekblad, I believe. The defenseman going to try to make a move, and oh, Mason does not control his rebound, and it is shoved into the net by Trocheck. Let's watch this one again. Mason just could not find it in time. But Trocheck's got his third of the playoffs now. In four games, he just kind of shovels that on home as his momentum takes that puck right in the net. And yeah, it's not off the skate. That's a good goal. Use the stick, and it's 2-0 Panthers. Okay, faceoff immediately after that goal. Won by the Panthers. Coming on in, and the slapper. Oh, my. Okay. Mason's got to have that puck. I'm sorry, but he does. You might want to consider a goaltending change just to snap the Flyers out of this. As far as we're concerned, keep them in there because we're rolling. It's 3-0. And now the crowd in Philly is stunned. Yeah, you got to have that save from that far out. He's just putting that on net, trying to see if he's rattled. And clearly he's rattled because he could not get the trapper on that one. 3-0 Panthers on the road about halfway through this game. But hold up, Flyers are not dead yet. Got some momentum coming into the zone. Get the goaltender Luongo sliding one way, and this puck beats him on the opposite side of the net. It's now 3-1. That was a power play goal, and now we're going to have to watch the momentum swing here. We do not want to give up this 2-goal lead. There's a block on defense, and here we go the other way. Let's see what we can do with this rush. Oh, put right on his tape where he can blast it past Mason again from distance. That was beautiful there as you got the right-handed shot coming up ice, and he gets the puck in a position where he can get it around the defense and pass the goaltender, and it's now 4-1. We got that 3-goal lead back, 7.5 minutes to play. Into the zone, though, are the Flyers, and really? Just like that, I thought we were in pretty good defensive position, but nah. That one is hammered past Roberto Luongo. I don't think it was tipped. I think it was in straight on the shot, and it's 4-2. Okay, still the 2-goal lead, under a minute to play. Goaltender's been pulled, and that is a turnover coming down ice, and just wants to make sure nobody's in his way of rifling that in the empty net. It looks like it's going to be a victory for the Panthers to even this series at 2 games apiece. The final seconds come off the clock, and it is official. This series is all now tied up, knotted up 2 games apiece as the Panthers get to celebrate on the Flyers' ice. So both teams have stolen a game on the road, and we're right back where we started with this thing, all evened up, 3 stars of the night, as the Panthers take all 3. But now we shift back to Florida for game 5 and a chance to get the series lead and be right where we expected to be. Let's see if we can get it tonight in front of the home crowd. The Flyers, yeah, looking to take a 3-2 lead, but we don't want that to happen. So let's try to focus on being sharp early. Just a few minutes into the game here and a rush up ice. And a nice back pass and a blast. It's going to beat him. Mason. Oh, wow. And he gets kind of run over by the goal scorer there for good measure at the end. But it's 1-0 for the home team. And the building is going crazy already. Waving those playoff towels as Riley Smith scores his first of the series on the power play. And we are going to get another look at this. A nice, nifty pass entering the zone there. And Riley Smith not shy whatsoever about rifling this one on net. Mason cannot come up with a save, and he gets shoved there by Riley Smith for a little insult to injury there. And, oh, a turnover. You see there we wanted to play that up the boards instead, the forecheck. And that puck squirted right out front. And, well, that spells disaster for the Panthers, as Claude Giroux is on the board for the third time of the series. You see, it was him with the pressure behind the net. He comes right back into position by the goal mouth and is able to get that puck home on the rebound. We got a 1-1 hockey game, and it got a lot quieter in here all of a sudden. Into the second period now. Losing a draw on our own end. Not good, but we do get the puck back there by blocking a shot. Living legend Jaromir Jagr comes up ice. A little bit of a deke here and there. And then he beats Mason with the shot, taking the lead back for the Panthers 2-1. I'm telling you, Jaromir Jagr probably play up until he's 50 if he wants to. I mean, the guy's already fast approaching his 45th birthday in February. I mean, what more can you ask from the guy? What an NHL career he has had. And he gets another marker right there for the Panthers, who are looking for their third goal, and they get it. Nifty play behind the net. They are just swarming. They smell blood here, and they were able to make it 3-1. That pass gave Mason no chance to stop it, as that is some good work in the zone, and Alexander Barkov finishes it off. Let's watch as they're swarming the net. Nice position by Barkov, just kind of laying back a little bit there, ready for that pass, and he essentially puts it into a wide open net to make it 3-1 Florida. Let's see if they can continue that lead here in the third period. This puck around behind the net and a huge hit right there. And, well, that crushing hit directly set up the goal. That's Claude Giroux with the hit and the pass to Wayne Simmonds, who has his fourth of the playoffs. And we have a 3-2 hockey game. It's getting really close here, too close for comfort. That pass across the crease, and oh, wow, okay. Well, just like that, the computer decides that it's time to tilt the ice a little bit here and get the Flyers back in the game. At least that's what it feels like from my perspective, is all of a sudden they just turned it on. The ghost, Shane Gossespierre, gets the goal, and we're all tied at three, and we got some problems here because the Flyers have all the momentum and they're swarming, but here we come down the ice trying to change things. That is on net. It's a save by Mason, but taken away on the forecheck and put in the net. It's Riley Smith again. Check out the effort by our forecheckers here, getting that puck back. That's pretty much a one-man show for Riley Smith right there. That's going to be an unassisted goal for him and his second of the night. Beautiful. All right, 4-3 is the lead, empty net. And we're going to get the empty net goal. No, he missed it right there. Second chance at it, and wow, deflected in. No goaltender to deflect it by, but Shaw gets the deflection and the goal anyway. 5-3. You can pretty much put it in the books now. Just 21.9 seconds left. Logan Shaw, his first goal of the playoffs, and it comes on an empty net goal. How about one more for good measure? We missed the net right there. Doesn't look like it is going to happen, but it doesn't matter. We've got all we need in a 5-3 victory, and we take a 3-2 series lead with a chance to end it in Philly in Game 6. Well, ever since we lost Game 3 and went down in the series 2-1, we held that team meeting. It helped some people with their morale. It hurt others. But what you cannot argue is since that time, we are now 2-0, and we are on the verge of winning this playoff series, which is what we were expected to do all along, being the number one seed. So we take to the ice at the Wells Fargo Center, knowing that we have a chance to win this thing right here. We don't need to force Game 7. We don't want them to force Game 7, although it would be at home, and the home crowd would like that, but let's end it tonight, and there's a nice play right there, standing right in the crease, and able to knock that home, and it's a nice pass to set it up. It's going to be Barkov with the goal, his third of the playoffs, but watch this pass right here, right on the tape. Mason has no chance. 1-0 Panthers. You got to love the early momentum to quiet this crowd and get the job done. That's exactly what we're trying to do here. So face off at center ice, and we've got the momentum. And how about that pass right there? You got to be kidding me. Riley Smith fires it home to make it 2-0, and this place is stunned. Stunned, I tell you. His third of the playoffs. And what a setup, though. Look at the little pass. Puts it right on his tape, right in position to shoot. Does not have to really do anything to get himself in position right there, set up perfectly, and he does not miss. So 2-0 Florida, although we know how the computer works in these situations here. They're going to bring it. They're going to bring it, and Luongo doing his best to keep it out of the net, but the rebound just too juicy right there. Wide open net, and he buries it. So Matt Reed gets his second of the playoffs, and we've got a brand new hockey game. Flyers in it with momentum and in our zone here, but we're going to try to get it out. All right, coming up ice, Panthers, another drop pass, another blast, and another rebound, and this one's put home, but not by us. The defenseman scores on his own net, obviously not trying to do that, but his momentum apparently took him into the net, or at least the puck. Look at that, he's trying to get it around the back of the net and back to the boards, and instead, pressure right in his face by Jágr there, and the puck ends up in the net. That's really... really tough there when that kind of thing happens to you. He's going to have to shake it off, but they are down 3-1. Well, make it 3-2. Flyers not wasting any time. This period gets crazy. Just hold on to your hats here because it's now 3-2. Yeah, we're not done in this period. Face-off in the Flyers zone and right off that face-off. A nice win there of the draw, and the puck ends up in the back of the net. It's now 4-2 as the Panthers can feel it. They want to close this thing out. And that's going to go a long way to helping their cause. So face-off right after the goal. Are the Flyers packing it in? Are they done? Well, here they come right into our zone. And, look at that. A lucky rebound off the block shot right on the stick again. And Luongo, nothing he can do. It's 4-3. Man, like I said, crazy period right now. And it's still only about halfway through the second. Luongo makes a save, trying to keep the Flyers from tying this. Big Nick Bjugstad gets ahead of steam. He beats the goaltender right there and makes it 5-3. We've answered back. Both teams taking their shots. Wow. I love how we keep answering here. And that is a beautiful goal by Nick Bjugstad. His first of the playoffs. And he puts the move on right here. And before he is thrown down to his knees behind the goal, he's able to put it home. That's a great goal right there, and it gets us our two-goal lead back. All right, final minute. Goalie is pulled, empty net. That shot just wide. Can we get the empty netter and end this? Oh, yep, that's pretty much going to seal it. He's going to take it all the way down to one, kill some time, and two to make sure he does not miss that empty net. 6-3. That should be the final blow that ends the series and the Flyers' season. You see the crowd not too excited about that, but the Panthers have really poured it on here in these last three games. They're going to win it in six. Last shot is stopped.
And the game is over. The series is over. They've won the series and they'll move on. No lower low in hockey than seeing your hope shattered like this. This is not the time to analyze it. That comes later. The handshakes are first. It is a most noble part of a collision sport, an exhausting series of games. Handshakes replace all the adrenaline from the last hours.
All right, so it's wrapped up after losing two of the first three games. We come back and win the series in six, and we'll be moving on to take on the Tampa Bay Lightning, who swept their first round series. Yeah, this should be a good matchup here. We're going to have to bring our A game if we want to move on to the Eastern Conference Finals. We'll see you next time for more Panthers hockey.